In South Africa, linguistic history is being made after students at the University of Cape Town graduated from an indigenous language course with roots that date back more than 200,000 years. The Coy-San are known to be one of the earliest inhabitants of southern Africa, but their language was mostly lost through the ages, with colonialism said to be a major cause. CGTN's Travers Andrews has more with this report.
With one-third of the world's 6,000 languages all spoken in Africa, the continent's linguistic roots are certainly deep. But Khoikhoi Kavab is a language so rare that there are only said to be 167,000 speakers left. Today, though, there's reason to celebrate, as these lot are the new crop that will play an important role in preventing the total loss of the language. They graduated from the University of Cape Town's first Khoikhoi Kavab language course, a move which the institution hopes will be an historical intervention.
History in the making. This is the first time of its kind at any university that this is taking place. We urge other universities and other institutes to see the important significance of doing the promotion, the preservation and the development of Khoikhoi Kavab, of Khoikhoi language. This is such an important thing because we have lost so much things, and here we have an opportunity to, within our lifetimes, to actually restore something that's so invaluable. This is not only something that we're doing for present people, it's also for future.
Most of its speakers are centered in the greater Namaqualand area, but here in the Western Cape, there remains not only a community that cherishes their rich history, language and culture, but new speakers wanting to learn more.
I found out about it, my mom found out about it, we came straight away, and the course itself was an amazing journey to go on, to learn this language that was used by my ancestors, by everyone's ancestors. Definitely made a change in my life, and it makes a change in everyone's life, just even to know a few words out of it.
The course is being offered by the University Center for Extramural Activities and comes after the Traditional and Khoisan Leadership Bill was just signed into law by President Cyril Ramaphosa. Khoikhoi Kavab may be one of Africa's most endangered indigenous languages, but this university has even bolder plans than its introductory course. It also aims to make it the fourth language at the institution, after isiXhosa, English and Afrikaans, which will assist efforts in promoting indigenous Khoisan languages and multilingualism at the institution.
We need our official language status. In fact, we also need each of the various languages, like the Kung, the Nama, the Khoikhoi Kavab, the Ngu, the Khoi Dam, and all the languages belong to the Khoi and the San people, the Bushmen. Each one needs their own language board, so it can be more specialized development, because now broadly they are all clustered into one language body.
For now, though, the ceremony caps off years of activism work done by the Khoisan community and academics to further enrich the pool of knowledge that can make this linguistic treasure something that is never lost to the ages. Travis Andrews, CGTN, Cape Town.